I'm Norman Wildberger. Today we're going to go over the last two questions in the quiz that I presented in WildTrig 16. The last question in particular is quite interesting and will give us a chance to explore medians, altitudes, and vertex bisectors of a triangle. Question 6 is an interesting problem too, concerning inversion in a circle. So we have a circle like this, center O, and we have two points A and B on this vertical line. And from this point, we draw lines like this intersecting the circle at points E and F. And we wanted to show that this distance times this distance, in such a case, is equal to the square of the radius. So what we do, first of all, is we scale our diagram so that the circle has radius 1. And then we can even choose this point A to have coordinates 0, t. The thing we need to know is that in that case, this point E is given by a rational parameterization of the circle. In terms of t, it's 1 minus t squared over 1 plus t squared, 2t over 1 plus t squared. Now if we look at the point B with coordinates 0, 1 over t, so the 1 over t times the t will be equal to 1, which is the square of the radius, then that point B gives us the point F exactly in the same way, but now with the t up here replaced with a 1 over t. So let's have a look at this expression, which is obtained from this one, by replacing t with 1 over t. See what happens. When you expand this, or multiply by t squared, you get minus this. And when you expand this out by multiplying by t squared, you get exactly the same expression that appeared here. What you see is that the point E and the point F are almost the same, except that the x-coordinate of F is negative the x-coordinate of E, which means exactly that E and F are reflections in this vertical line. So the relation between E and F being reflections corresponds to the relation between A and B being inverses with respect to the circle. Question 7 concerned a triangle and three lines from the vertices. The first line is a median, meaning that it goes to the midpoint of the opposite side, here called M1. The second line is an altitude, meaning that it goes to the foot of the perpendicular to the other side, here called F2. And the third line, A3 to B3, where this is a vertex bisector, meaning these two spreads are the same or the angles are the same. And we wanted to know, what is this distance, what is this distance, and what is this distance? So let's look at those three things separately. First of all, just the median situation. So here's the triangle again. We were looking at a specific triangle, so with quadrants of 16, 9, and 4. If that's all 4, then one of these is just 1, a quarter of it. And the spreads of the triangle we computed last time, they're given as 15 over 16 and 135, 256 here and here. All right, so how are we going to find this quadrants? Call it Q. Well, we have two triangles. We can use the cross line each. So in this triangle, the cross log is 9 plus 1 minus Q, all squared, equals 4 times 9 times 1 minus that spread. There it is there. And in this triangle, the cross log gives 16 plus 1 minus Q, all squared, equals 4 times 16 times 1 minus this spread, which is that. So we have two quadratic equations in Q. Now you could go ahead and solve both of those quadratic equations for Q and see a common solution. But a simpler way is to simply take the difference between these two quadratic equations. The Q squared terms will cancel and you'll just get a linear equation in Q. It's a generally good trick. You have two quadratic equations, take their difference to get a linear equation. So when you do that, then there's only one viable solution, and it's 23 over 2. And so the distance that we're interested in, the length of the median, is the square root of that. I'd also like to mention that there's a general formula that tells you in general, for a general triangle, in terms of the quadrants of the triangle, what a quadrants of a median is. Here's the general formula. In our situation, we have 9, 16, and 4 here. And that would be 50 minus 4 over 4, which is 46 over 4, which is the same. So this general case can be found on page 137 of my book, Divine Proportions. The second question involves this triangle and the altitude. We want to find the length of that altitude. That's pretty easy, because we know that this quadrant's Q divided by that quadrant's 9 is equal to the spread there. So this equation is immediately solvable for Q, and so the altitude is the square root. Some auxiliary things that we're going to use just in a while. Notice that this quadrant's P is just the difference between 9 and Q. And the quadrant's R here is the difference between 4 and Q. Both of these by Pythagoras' theorem, so we can calculate those quadrants as easily as well. The last line was a vertex bisector. From A3, we take the line which splits this spread into two equal pieces. Let's call those little spreads S. So both of those spreads together combine to give a spread of 135 over 256. So one of the interesting laws that we derived, which is a consequence of the triple spread formula, is that in this case, we have to look at the expression 4 times S times 1 minus S. That was the logistic map. So 4 times 1 S times 1 minus S equals that. We get a quadratic equation in S. That's two solutions. And this is the one that we want. The other one corresponds to the other vertex bisector, would be out here. Once we know this 5/32nd for this spread, then we have two triangles here, and we can solve for this spread. I'll call it R. We use the triple spread formula in this triangle, which is here, and the triple spread formula in this triangle. It's the same R there. That's there. Notice this is a kind of an alternate formula, an alternate version of the triple spread formula that I haven't shown you before. It's exactly equivalent to the usual one. It illustrates the thing as a quadratic equation in the unknown R. How do we solve? We're going to take the difference between those two quadratic equations, and then we get a linear equation in R. So now, putting things together, we found that in this triangle we have little s is 5 over 32, and this spread R is 5 over 8. So the spread law in this triangle A1, A3, B3 is the spread divided by Q equals 5 eighths over 16 equals 5 32nds over R. We'll call this one R. That allows us to solve for Q. Q is 6. And it also allows us to solve for R. R is 4. And similarly, if you look at the spread law in this triangle, then you can determine also that P is equal to 1. So putting everything together, we've now found this information about these three lines. The median splits this side in the ratio in quadrants 1 and 1. The altitude created quadrants 441 over 64 and 121 over 64. While these two quadrants are 4 and 1. So I asked, are these three lines actually concurrent? Well, if they are, then this quadrant times this quadrant times this quadrant has to be equal to the product of this quadrant times this quadrant times this quadrant. And are they equal? No, they're not. They're almost equal, but they're not. And so the green lines are not concurrent. So that concludes our quiz. Next time, I'm going to enlarge rational trigonometry into a whole new domain by introducing finite fields. So we're going to look at geometry over finite fields and what it means to do trigonometry in that domain. It's a very exciting development. I hope you'll join me. I'm Norman Wildberger, and thanks for listening.